Hello, and happy new year. And to start off this new year, we're going to be looking at a rather powerful unit. A big unit, well, kind of big. Anyway, it's Achilles, available to the 1st Guards Armoured, 1st Polis Armoured, and 3rd Canadian Infantry Division. In 1943, the British ordered and received a bunch of M10 Wolverines from the Americans. After getting them, they realised, why don't we just put the 17-pounder in here instead, it's more powerful. And so they did. They removed the American gun and put the British gun in. And they called it the Achilles. That would be the Achilles heel of the German armour, as it could easily go through German armour. During the Normandy campaign, initially, it only had roughly over 100 of these vehicles available, which isn't a lot. So when the British hit the beaches, they're still mainly using the American M10 Wolverines. By the end of the war, they had produced just over 1,000 Achilles. In its role, the Achilles was meant to be a more quick deployable anti-tank gun. It wasn't meant to attack, as it had a slow turret rotation speed, which isn't all that good when you only have a few seconds to shoot at a German Panther before it shoots you. So they would put it in defensive positions where it has cover, and well, it shoots any German tank that comes into range. And in that role, it was pretty effective. And that's pretty much how the British used it throughout the entirety of the war. In-game, the Achilles is a 170-point tank destroyer available to the 1st Polish Armour Division during B phase and to the Guards Armoured and 3rd Canadian Infantry Divisions during C phase. It has two weapons. So the armament consists of one 17-pounder gun with 6 accuracy, 6 rate of fire, 16 AP of 40 shots, 2 HE of 10 shots, and 1.2km range. It's the most powerful allied anti-tank gun in game, and you can easily deal with Panthers and Tigers with this gun. You know, King Tigers will still prove to be a bit of a pain in the butt. Also, it's not great in terms of anti-infantry, as it only has 2 HE and 10 shots, but you also have a 50 cal machine gun, which is a 50 cal machine gun, and you got a whopping 1,000 rounds to use. Pop down to miscellaneous stats, you got 8 frontal armor, 3 outside, 3 out back, and you are an open top vehicle, so bombs will blow you up. You have very bad stealth, a speed of 28km off-road and 63km on the road, and low optics capability. In battle, your Achilles is really your go-to heavy-duty anti-tank tank destroyer. Its gun can easily deal with the majority of German heavy tanks that you have to deal with, and will easily cut through Stugs and Panzer IVs like a hot knife through a lot of butter. Now, compared to the Firefly, which is a unit available to all the divisions that can get the Achilles, it's really quite an interesting trade-off. So Achilles is 40 points cheaper, and it does have the 50 cal, but the Firefly does have 3 extra points of armor. And the open top does mean when a JU-88 does come crashing down and bombs your entire line, it has a much better chance of actually surviving the onslaught, when Achilles would die pretty easily to bombs being dropped on top of it. Personally, I prefer the Achilles more, just because I find the 40 points difference to be a rather big difference, and it is better in the anti-infantry department, as the 50 cal helps out quite a lot. It's really a very useful unit to have in all three of the divisions, and I highly recommend it. If you need a good heavy tank duty tank buster, the Achilles is your best bet. I was going to make an Achilles heel joke, but I can't even think of one. So I'm going to end this off, and this has been another Rang Rouge Unit of the Reek. See you guys for the rest of the year for more Unit of the Reeks. And as usual, please just take it easy.